Good evening, everybody.
Hello.
We are here in downtown Las Vegas. Uh-huh. We are going to check in at the Circa.
Yeah, we've never stayed here before.
No, it's going to be our first time. But the big question is going to be, does Circa offer enough for you to stay in downtown Las Vegas?
Mm-hmm. Is it a resort enough, like the ones on this trip?
Right.
Would you come and consider staying here?
Yeah. No.
And what's interesting is this is a 21 and over only casino.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Now, when you park at the, they call it the Taj Mahal?
Something like that, baby.
Yeah, like a fancy, a very fancy parking lot. Uh-huh. They have cool, like, neon stuff, escalators, everything. Mm-hmm. But before you walk in over the bridge, they ID everybody.
They do.
Mm-hmm. They make sure you're 21 and over.
Yeah.
And all the entrances outside on Fremont Street, same thing, ID everybody.
Yes, they do.
So basically, there's no kids allowed here.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we're going to go check in.
Yes.
Give you a room tour. And then we're going to get some eats.
Yeah. Yeah. The place is going to close in like an hour. So we got to hurry up.
Yeah. It's about 10 p.m.
Yeah.
Yeah. Welcome to our room tour. We are on the 18th floor. We have a king size bed. As you walk in the door, give them a tour of the bathroom.
These are the bathrooms, two separate sinks. And you can turn the lights brighter or softer. I like this bathtub. It actually has a closing door.
Right. It's a walk-in shower.
Mm-hmm. And it has even a little step there. And it has all of your amenities. And here's the toilet there.
I looked in the closet, and sadly, there's no robe or slippers. That's okay. Come on in. Here's your climate control.
It has Celsius and Fahrenheit.
Right. And we have a nice little desk and a fridge, and they do give you some complimentary Circa waters. And they said, you know what, if you run out, just give them a call downstairs and they'll bring out more water. And I have an ice bucket, good size framed TV, along with a sitting couch. Yeah. And look, another little couch. Cool little picture on the wall. And this is what, I guess, controls the room, your lighting, and you could contact the front desk, housekeeping, and such.
King size bed.
Yeah, nice king size bed. But the cool part is we have a pool view and part of Fremont. I know it's a little bit dark out right now, so we'll give you a better shot in the morning.
You only can see us. There you go. There's Fremont. It's a little empty, but it's a little bit cold out there.
Yeah.
And this is their stadium swim.
Oh, yeah.
Big sports book. It's a little late, so the pool is closed.
Right. We will try to get down there tomorrow and give you a ground view of all, like, six pools they have over here. So in case you're wondering how much this cost, I got on Hotel Tonight, that app that I use for last-minute bookings, $144, including taxes, for two nights. So that's $72 per night, plus resort fee of, I think, $45 per day. It's a great deal because I know when this hotel first opened, or even on the weekends right now, it's way up there in price. So for $144 for two nights, it's a great deal. So that's it. This is the room tour here at the Circa.
It's nice.
Yes. That was a pretty cool room.
It was, yes.
Yeah. So it's nice staying here in downtown at a new hotel.
Mm-hmm.
So now we are at East 8.
Yes.
This is the Asian fusion place, I think?
Yes, and we tried it a long time ago when it first opened, but not everything was on the menu yet. Now it's been open for a few years.
Oh, yeah.
Everything should be there.
Yeah, several years, right?
Yes.
So now we're going to pop in, get some late night eats.
And it's open till 11, and so we just made it.
Yes.
We have small plates on one side. And then on the other side, we have more small plates, and then we have entrees as well.
Yeah, the menu definitely looks more expanded from the last time we came here.
It does. So we're going to look this over and see what we're going to get. Here I got the steam egg. It is traditional steam egg topped with Topico caviar, bonito flakes, and soy sauce. So if you can see this bonito flakes, they're kind of just moving on their own, kind of with the air, but it looks like they're alive, but they're not alive. So I'm gonna go ahead and try this out. This looks really good. I've had this before, but not this type. And this is, you can say the steaming is more like an appetizer. Let's try this out. This steaming, extremely flavorful. It tastes like a steam egg that they really whipped well, and they steam it so it has this nice sheen, not like a scrambled egg. It has that soy sauce that has a great flavor, and those bonito flakes and onions just bring out that flavor. You have to try this. If you haven't tried this before, it's a little bit different. Yeah, if you like egg, you're gonna love this one.
Another small plate appetizer we ordered is the grilled lamb chops. Look at that. You could grate grill marks on it. On the menu, it says it's seasoned with cumin and salt and pepper. And that's it. I definitely smell a lot of like Indian kind of spices. I'm not entirely sure what cumin tastes like on its own, but here we go. Oh man, this is delicious. It's got the great grilled charcoal flavor to it. It's got the right amount of like fattiness with this, and it's cooked at a perfect like medium, rare to medium. Very tender. Yeah, this is great. I think I'm a fan of cumin now. A little bit of salt and pepper with that cumin. Yeah, not spicy at all. Delicious.
As you saw, they have a wide variety, thank you. Wide array, that's what I wanted to say, of tea. So we got the White Cloud Jasmine tea. Cheers. Hot. Oh. Great, strong jasmine flavor. If you're a big jasmine tea fan, you're gonna really like this one. It has that great, robust, like really good jasmine, which is kind of like a flowery side, but kind of on the tart side too. It's a very good tea if you're a jasmine tea lover.
For my entree, I got the Dan Dan noodles with ground pork. You're given a choice between ground chicken or pork, and I'm a porky kind of guy, so that's what I got. They give it to you like this, and they give you these tongs here, so you just mix it yourself. Mix it all up. Here we go, let's go in for a taste test of this. This looks wonderful. Oh yeah, I'm just trying to pull some noodles out over here. It's really like kind of sticky, I know from that peanut sauce. Here we go. What really comes through is that peanut sauce. Very peanut sauce forward. The noodles are cooked perfectly. And that seasoned ground pork, yeah, that is very good. And I'll try some of the bok choy with it. Bok choy, nice and fresh. This is a great Dan Dan noodle. I will definitely order this again. This hits the spot for my late night eats.
This one has the little spicy pepper on the side of it. Is it spicy?
Not spicy at all, nope. So it's pretty good. It's mild, I'd say. I'm not even getting a medium, it's mild.
I got the pad thai. They have pad thai with either chicken or pork. I got it with the pork. I have all the lovely little goodies here, and they gave me bean sprouts inside, and they gave me extra bean sprouts. They must know the way I like it. So I'm gonna go mix this up. I want that little bit of crunch still with that bean sprout. I'm gonna liven it up also with some lime here. Let's go ahead and sprinkle on a little bit of lime. Just like that. And let me get ready for that first bite. Look at this first bite. I have a little bit of the bean sprouts in there. I have the green onions. I have the pad thai noodles, and I have the pork. I love the flavor of this pad thai. It has a great, really good umami with it. I like it with the lime because it really limes it up. And what I like the best is these green sprouts. The ones they put on the side, I put them in here, and that gives it that amazing crunch as you're eating it. This, a very good dish. I'd get this definitely again. You have to come and try this one.
That was a delicious late night meal at 8 East.
Yeah, it was so good.
It was. You know, for me, the highlight was those grilled lamb chops.
Those are really good.
Oh, yeah. That was my favorite.
Yeah, they have so much stuff on the menu that I wanted to try. They had some musubi bites that looked really good.
They had chicken skin, too.
And that chicken skin, yeah. So we had to definitely go back there.
Yes.
But that was just a perfect meal because it is a little late, but we're going to end our day today with dessert from Jackpots. It's 24 hours.
Yes.
And it's their coffee place and pastry place. They do have breakfast sandwiches there. We're going to go see what they have. So again, this place is 24 hours. And look at the beautiful pastries and little sandwiches they have.
These muffins are like outrageous. And they have some sweet stuff here. Look at that. Oh man. We have a lot of choices. So we have to pick one.
Look around and see which one we want.
We got our dessert. Mm-hmm. I got to hold up the mic close because it is very loud with music over here.
Yes.
What did we get?
We got the churro upside down cake. Lorna was very nice to us and warmed it up just a tad bit. This looks absolutely amazing.
Yeah. They have a few of these upside down cakes.
They do.
And she could recommend any of these.
Yes. So I'm going to go ahead. Here you go, babe.
Oh, B, okay, here we go. That is good.
A little dry, but it tastes really good with this, with the outside and the icing.
Yes.
It's very good.
You really get that taste of that cinnamon and sugar.
Mm-hmm.
And that little bit of frosting, to me, that is enough.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Yeah, perfect amount of sweetness.
Good upside down cake. Wow. This is really good.
It
really tastes like a churro cake on a cake side, though.
It does, and it's going to match our cup of coffee perfectly.
So we're going to finish this off, and we'll see you guys in the morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone.
We're going to start breakfast here at Saginaw's.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this place is 24 hours, and we always come here for their pastrami sandwich.
Right.
But we never had anything else besides that.
Yes, so we're here for breakfast. The breakfast is served here from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m.
Yes, right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm looking forward to see what they got.
Let's go, babe. Let's go, babe.
Me, me, me.
Me, me, me. They have a lot of breakfast stuff. So they have anything from meat lovers to vegetarian. It's a lot to choose from.
I see a loco moco. That's very interesting.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I got the, I'm about to say loco moco. Sorry, babe. I got the corned beef hash right here. Looks delicious. It comes with toast. And then for an upcharge, I got some silver dollar pancakes. Have to try them out. Go ahead and try this corned beef hash. As you can tell, you can have your eggs any way you want it. I got the over easy eggs right here. There is the corned beef hash, all freshly done. And you know me, I'm a fan of the cheap stuff. So we'll see how this fares up. Go ahead. I want all of this yummy, yolky goodness all over this corned beef hash. Just like that. I'm gonna go ahead and take my first bite right here. All with that egg, with corned beef hash, with the toast. And you know sometimes corned beef hash comes with eggs and something else. This one is just straight up corned beef hash, eggs, toast. That's it. House-made corned beef. You can really taste that great corned beef flavor. The corned beef is so juicy. It's like they take the fatty portions of the corned beef and they kind of mix it all up with some peppers, some onions in there, some potato in there. Big fan of this corned beef. And it's a perfect sharing size, especially because of all the toast they give you. This is really good. I'd come if you're a big corned beef hash person and the fancy pants kind, this is perfect.
When I saw they had loco moco on the menu, I have to try it out. Here we go. This looks beautiful. Look at that egg right on top. It's a great fried egg. You can just see the little crispy edges from being fried. Good size hamburger patty over a bed of rice, gravy. Yeah, never had it presented like this before. Kind of fancy pants. So let's cut into this. Oh, yep, there we go. Look at that. This is pretty darn good. I have to say, the gravy is nice and rich. That hamburger patty's got that nice sear on it. Of course, the egg just makes everything like smooth and creamy. Yeah, so the hamburger patty is really the star over here. They're really good. I think if you're a local Mocha fan and you don't want to walk to the California hotel from here, I think this will fit the bill. Yep, it's really good. The local Mocha. Could recommend this one.
I had to try these silver dollar pancakes. I already put butter. Here's the syrup.
Now those are some pretty big silver dollars.
Yeah. I know, I thought it was going to be a little bit smaller, but these are pretty good sized pancakes here. Let's try this out. Oh yeah, nice and fluffy. They're actually a perfect size to share. There's a meal that comes with three of these. But we decided just to get it on the side. Really good pancakes. Very fluffy. Like a little bit of maybe like a vanilla or something in it. These are good pancakes. If you're in the mood for some good pancakes, this is the one to get. Would I make a special trip for them? Probably not, because they're just really good pancakes. But you know that you can get some top quality pancakes here at a 24-hour place. Breakfast was delicious. Now we're gonna go look around the resort.
Circa has a big casino area, two levels. So we're on the upper level. That's where most of the eateries are at. And also the entrance to Stadium Swim. We're gonna go check that out right now.
Here's the little rules here.
And how much does it cost?
And if you're staying at any of these hotels, if you're staying at Circa, the D or Golden Gate, it is included with your room stay. If you're not staying here, it's a general admission price of $25.
This is probably the longest escalator here in Las Vegas, all the way up.
And it is next level swim.
Yeah, so you definitely want to hold the handrails or keep your balance. I'd hold the handrails.
During the summer when it's really warm, this queue is probably packed.
They even have lockers for you to use.
This is such a beautiful place. We're going to prove it to you now. Welcome to Stadium Swim. This is a cool way of walking into the pool. When you walk into this ramp here, it goes straight into the pool. We've been to a few sports book in our day. I think on the strip, Caesars has the most elaborate one. Circa beats them by a mile. This is just at Kapool. Tons of pools here. They're all, I believe, temperatured. They have a DJ stand right in the center. The bar is fully opened on one side. They even have a grill here. And you can watch sports all day.
Yeah, they have private cabanas here to rent, and a lot of these also.
Yeah.
Of course, it is kind of breezy and cold this morning.
It is.
That's why it's empty.
And the pool opens at 8 o'clock. Right now, I think it's about 9. Yeah, right now it's 9. But yeah, it's a little bit breezy, a little bit cold. You can just see how busy this gets early in the morning during the summer. Kind of interesting. This is a game I've ever seen before, Buffalo and Friends.
You're gonna give it a try. Maybe you'll win something.
You never know.
Yeah.
Not yet.
Come on, big money.
Big money.
Well, that's a start.
Got something.
Yeah. We got $2. Yay!
Biggest win yet. $8.
Nice.
And it's got it on tens. Not bad. Bonus time. Let's see if we can get anything.
Yes, yes. Come on. Big winner, big winner.
Guaranteed at least $21.
Oh, yeah. Guaranteed that.
Minor. Oh. $21.
Okay. Okay. Not bad. Not we'll bad. Take it. Yeah.
We found it to the fitness center. Let's go check it out. There's some people working out, and so we're going to go around and see. We have a water station here, and there's some people working out, so we're just going to do a quickie.
They do have a sundry store and a souvenir shop. Let's go check it out. I do like this shirt. Check it out. The Vegas Vicky shirt.
Now, this is a sports book. What I love about this sports book, it has your own stadium seating here. If you're not a big sports fan, but maybe your significant other is, it also has gambling along the sports book.
Yeah, very, very impressive.
It is. This is where you'll find me. I'm a big sports person. Baseball, now that the season just started, and basketball, you'll find me here.
Here on the first floor, right across from Circa Sports, is a lot of table games over here. Of course, they're doing some cleaning, some maintenance down here this morning, but on the weekends, I could see it being very crowded.
Now, you know the D has the long bar. This one has the mega bar. At least 100 seats here at this bar, and it's the longest bar in Vegas.
Yeah.
Or in the world? No, in Vegas.
I don't know about the world, but Las Vegas for
Las
sure.
Las Vegas for yeah. sure, yeah. What I like about here is that you really can't find this on the Strip, that these casinos down here, especially Circa, has an outdoor bar.
And right on the other side is Project Barbecue, which maybe we'll try out later.
And your entertainment's right here too, right outside the doors.
And when I saw a Godzilla machine, I have to play. You know me, I don't gamble too much, but I think this is based off like the new Godzilla versus King Kong movie that's out right now. Check that out. So you gave me how much, $20 in here?
I did.
All right, let me just play $1.20 since it's not my money. Here we go. All right, just take a look at that, look. You know, this is a nice time to plug the Godzilla Minus One. Is that what it's called? Mm-hmm. Oh, camera's not going. Yeah, that was an amazing movie. I recommend it if you haven't seen it already. And we're not winning anything yet over here. Well, I think Godzilla and King Kong skunked me at 10 cents. Yeah. It is lunchtime.
It is.
And we're going to try Victory Burgers.
Mm-hmm. Last time we were here again was like 3 years ago, huh, baby?
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we saw Project Barbecue outside. Mm-hmm. So I think we'll get one burger from here and something from Project Barbecue.
I think so. So we have to try all the locations, and then there's one more left, and that's tonight.
Yes.
We know which one we're gonna pick. It's gonna be a massive one. It's the Hangover Burger. We got the most outrageous burger. It is the Hangover Burger. And the only vegetables are in here are the waffle fries. There's nothing else in here. So it's an egg, it has cheese, it has grilled onions, giant patty, bacon. This looks just humongous. But it looks good. It smells delicious.
Let's cut into it.
Of course, that egg has to run all over the burger.
Let it run.
How's that look, baby?
It's about ready to pop. That's what it looks like.
Oh, did it pop yet?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
No, not yet.
But what's interesting is all the cheese right here is running out. We'll go ahead and pop this egg. Maybe it needs a little bit of help.
It does.
Here we go. How's that?
It looks like an egg. Never mind. Yeah.
Let's get this cut in half.
It is a toasted bun.
It is. Mm-hmm. The burgers are generally made medium well, unless you tell them to cook it differently. This is what it looks like in the inside. Looks like a hot mess in there.
Wow, look at that big piece of bacon. And these are half-pound burgers.
These are.
It looks huge. I'm going to try to hold it up. Look at this monstrosity. Monstrosity?
Yeah, it's a word.
Okay. Let's go for a big bite. That was a delicious bite. You're right, it is a hot mess. Parts of this burger are just dropping off in masses, but everything works together. It is delicious. I love that the patty is nice and charred. It's got that great beefy flavor to it. And this is very messy. It is like a fork and knife type of burger. And on the table, they give you like all these sauces. Boom Boom, mustard, the barbecue sauce, ketchup of course, mustard.
Turn this. You can see buffalo. But
I don't think it needs any sauces because it does have some sauce already on it. Look at that. They're just dripping. That cheese is just oozing off. That was a small bite. It was still messy. Yeah, it's a good burger. I'm impressed.
Got my bite ready. I have the waffle fry. I have the egg. I have the patty. I have a little bit of the bun right here. Let's try this out. My waffle. This is a very tasty burger. For us, it's definitely a shareable burger. That patty is very well seasoned. Waffle fry, it has a really nice crunch to it. And to top it off with that egg, that makes it really creamy. Oh yeah, this is a good one. I can taste the pepper in the burger. It has that little bit of spice of pepper. That's really good. But I wanna try this sauce, because I know it doesn't need any sauce. I want to try a little bit of this Boom Boom sauce, which is what they're known for. It looks almost like a Thousand Island mix, maybe, in there. Do a little bit. There you go. Let's try that out. It has that little bit of a Thousand Island taste, but it has also a little bit of vinegar that's added to it. And it has a little bit of heat. Really good, actually. Forget your bathing suit? No problem. They have Circa Swim, Circa Collection, and Circa Essentials.
Yeah, they got you covered. Yeah. Literally. Lunch number two at Project Barbecue. Mm-hmm.
They have the menu in the back. We're going to see what we can grab.
Yeah, now this is outside, right outside the Circa, but it is attached to it.
Yes.
We got the smoked pulled pork sandwich with house-made chips. Look at that, looks pretty good. And of course they give you some coleslaw. And you know how we do, we're gonna have to put a little bit of coleslaw on this. Oh yeah. How's that look? Looks pretty good? I think so, there we go. Well, from the sign, it says it's Carolina style barbecue. Oh, it's, yeah, here we go, look at that. Smoked pulled pork. The pulled pork is nice and tender. I'm not getting a whole bunch of smoke flavor out of the pulled pork, but the barbecue sauce is kind of sweet and tangy, so that's delicious. The coleslaw on top is nice and crunchy, nice and fresh. It's a pretty good barbecue sandwich. We almost got the brisket, but I think we're gonna get some more beef later tonight, so we try to get the pulled pork. Yep, so you gotta try it on now, babe.
Yep, look at those chips, babe. You didn't try the chips.
The house-made chips. These are really good. Yeah.
They're not stale?
No, not stale at all. In fact, you can kind of make your own little
Oh, it's falling apart.
It's not working well, babe.
It's not working. It's crumbling all over the place.
They're
you get
fresh.
The idea, though. You get the idea.
That's how you do it. Get a little bit of that pulled pork. Put it on this chick, nice and warm. Get some slaw. Put that on the chip too. Oops.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's a lot of
that's
slaw.
That's a lot of slaw. Hold on. There we go. Some slaw on that chip. Mm-hmm. Those chips are thick, thick chips and extremely crunchy. Pulled pork is good. Not getting a lot of smoke. The sauce is very light on it. It's a good pulled pork. Mm-hmm. If you're in the mood for a pulled pork sandwich, this is a good one to try.
There's one thing we want to show you, which was a legacy club.
Right.
And it goes at the very top, and it gives like a panoramic view of the whole downtown area.
Right, but it's elegant casual, so you have to dress up for it, pretty much.
Yeah, there's a strict dress code.
Yes, there
and,
is.
And even me with my polo shirt and my 5'11 pants did not qualify.
No, not at all.
Yeah. So if you do come, you know, semi-dressed up,
yeah,
check this place out. I don't believe, you don't have to be a guest of the hotel. Anyone
okay.
could come up here.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, check it out for us and tell us how it was.
How it is.
It is time for dinner.
Yes, it's the last but not least place that we, this is the last place that we're gonna hit up for the Circa, but this is the last place for the Circa. Does
yes.
that make sense?
It is Barry's Downtown Prime Steakhouse.
I think that
it
makes
is
sense.
Right behind us. We're at the bottom where Vegas Vicky is, right there. So we are gonna go inside and end this Circa weekend at a steakhouse.
Yes.
Ready?
Ready.
Let's go.
Look at the doorstop, it's so cute.
It's like a cow.
It is a cow.
Just got seated at a nice private booth.
Mm-hmm. It's really nice. It's very well lit. The lighting is not too dim, which is really nice. You can actually read the menu and or see your food. So that's always a plus.
It is.
In
it
a
is.
Fine dining location. This is the menu. I like it because it's a pretty nice, small, not a big book menu. Of course, they're known for their steaks. So those are the steaks right here and steaks right here. And they even have evening specials this week.
We have a lot of choices here. Mm-hmm. I know we'll pick something good.
We will. We have some focaccia bread right here and some butternut brioche and some butter with salt.
Yeah, the focaccia, it smells like a pizza.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, try it out.
Yeah, I'm gonna have a roll. These rolls are not warm, they are hot to the touch, so be careful, don't burn yourself. They're pillowy soft on the inside, really good chew on the outside, that little bit of butter, it's a good roll. It tastes like a really good yeasty roll, not like a sourdough or a French roll at all, it tastes like a little yeast roll.
This smells delicious. Let me try it out. Mm-hmm. This is delicious. Nice and soft, just like your yeast roll. It's got that fine layer of like tomato sauce, marinara type of sauce on it. It's just missing a little cheese, and it'd be like a little cheese pizza. This is delicious. Oh, yeah.
I got that surf and turf with the filet medallions. It is so cute, and it's very small.
It's so perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lobster tail, and do you know what kind of sauce that is on top?
I don't. I have to test it and see. And I got some of the cream corn.
Yes, all of their sides are a la carte.
Everything is a la carte, yes. So let me go ahead and try out the sauce. It's very familiar. Oh, truffle.
Oh, okay.
The truffle sauce, baby.
I can smell a little bit of it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So is it two medallions on
it's
the side?
It's two medallions. Here we go. Here, it's two medallions, a cute little lobster tail that's split in half. Here's the claw, here's the tail, and it's going ahead, and let's go ahead and try this medallion in. Very easy to cut. Hardly any effort to get this cut. That looks delicious, turned perfectly. Wow. I asked for it medium and it's perfectly cooked. It is so tender. Very good medallion. Let me go ahead and try out this tail. Go ahead, cut a little bit of this tail. Again, this is the surf and turf. That looks good.
How we doing?
Oh, perfect.
Very good, thank you.
All right,
enjoy.
Thank you. Very good lobster tail. Doesn't need any of the extra butter or anything like that. This is going to match perfectly. This is really good, highly recommended.
How's that truffle? Is it heavy, light?
It's a very truffly taste. So if you don't like truffle, I'd have them put the sauce on the side so you can at least try it. But it's a really good truffle taste that matches anything with it, but you know it's a truffle.
Now, we opted to skip the starters because, as you saw, we had a pretty good day of eating here at the Circa. So that's the reason why we went straight to the mains. So I got an 8-ounce filet and a loaded baked potato. And what I like about their loaded baked potato is they put everything in there for you. So everything kind of gets melted and combined and everything. But let's take a look at this filet. I think this is like a pepper, so I'm going to put that aside for right now. Oh, it is a pepper. Look at that. I'm not sure what kind, but I don't want any hot surprises. So let's cut into this. Oh, I can just see the crust and feel the crust as I cut through this filet. I asked for it medium, and it does look like a good medium. Here we go. That is a delicious filet. They just nailed it. This crust is nice and crusty. It is well seasoned. It does not need any additional steak sauce or anything like that. It is good to go as is. Let me try this baked potato right here. It looks really good. I don't know if you can see that, but they put all the ingredients in on the baked potato, and they like put in a salamander or something, because you can see how it kind of has that little burnt charcoal on top. So everything is just blended together well.
This is my cream corn. Look at that. Wow. And you can tell these sides are shareable. Since they're a la carte, they are shareable. Creamy, sweet. They're shareable, but I don't know if I want to share this.
Hey,
this is,
come on.
So good.
I'll give you some of my potato.
I'll think about it, and it's going to match my meal perfectly.
Our server asked, do you want to see the dessert menu? We say, sure. Here we go. Take a look at that. Some good stuff. But I think we're going to go for the one at the very bottom of the list. It's a sticky toffee butter cake. And what got us is it's got Tahitian vanilla bean ice cream. Tahitian. Sounds exotic. We gotta try it out. Here it is. The sticky toffee pudding cake with the Tahitian vanilla bean ice cream and some fresh whipped cream on here. Now, we're a fan of sticky toffee puddings. We always order it at all the Gordon Ramsay restaurants. Delicious. So let's see how this one is. Get a little bit of that, a little bit of this. Dredge it through. Oh, yeah. Looks like I've done this before. Nice and warm. So warm that you can see it's already melting the ice cream over here. This is fantastic. This is the perfect way to close our weekend here at the Circa, having some delicious dessert at an amazing steakhouse with an amazing date.
Thank you, my date.
You're welcome, babe.
This is soft. Look at that. It's gooey. It's melty. Look at that. Wow. Let's go ahead. Get my bite going on here. A little bit of fresh whipped cream. Anybody want a bite? Here we go. Very good. I'm surprised. Are you surprised we didn't get the baked Alaska? That seemed way heavy. This one's heavy too, but we're sharing it. Hopefully it won't be too bad.
Oh yeah. I think we made the right choice.
Yeah, I think so too.
That wraps up our stay here at the Circa Resort and in downtown.
The Barry Steakhouse is delicious.
Yes.
I highly recommend it. These steakhouses down here, other than Barry's, all these steakhouses down here in downtown, they compete with the ones on the Strip. I think even some of these ones here are better.
So I agree.
So if you haven't tried the steakhouses down here in downtown, you gotta come by and try these here.
For sure. Now, you know, the question that we started out, does the resort here have enough to keep you in that Circa bubble here in downtown and not miss the Strip?
Right, that's correct.
For me, I think it does.
Yes, for a weekend especially.
Yes.
It has your entertainment that is just right outside the door. This is a very loud hotel. It's 21 and over. Music is going constantly. It's a little bit quieter during the day, but during the night, it is a party hotel.
It
you
is.
You never come down here, you have to visit it.
Right.
Beautiful hotel. If you're a sports person, you should have already been here. I don't know why you haven't been here if you're a sports person.
Yes, so this sports bar, I mean, the whole booking area, it's overwhelming.
It is.
So many screens.
Yes.
Not only in the hotel, but over there at the pool area.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
The same thing.
And it's sports here. Even though sports are not going on 24/7 here at this hotel, they are going 24/7.
Right, right. So how did you feel? Do you think this is worth a weekend stay at the Circa?
This is definitely worth a weekend stay for me because everything is so close. I just can walk outside and there's entertainment right there. They have the bar that's right outside. The food is delicious here. It is the same price as you would get on the Strip, but a lot less walking.
Yes. Now, there are a lot of bars and lounges here.
Right.
That we didn't hit up because it was kind of a non-drinking weekend for us.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but there are plenty of bars here.
Yeah, so I don't think you would really miss the Strip unless you have certain favorite places. If you don't have certain favorite places and you really want to visit something different, I'd come here.
Yes, and to maintain clear transparency, we're not sponsored by Circa. We pay for all of our meals.
We did.
And our stay.
We did.
Yes. Do you have any shout-outs?
I do. Ribby, happy birthday. Pam Farrow, happy birthday. Olaf, happy birthday. And Jane, Eric, and Caitlin, thank you for saying hi to us. We saw them here at the Circa.
Yes.
Thank you for the lovely family that said hi to us as we were coming down to Barry's Prime.
Right, they're locals here.
Thank you so much for all of everybody who came to say hi to us when we went to the cow. We were walking around.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much for saying hi.
Yeah, we truly appreciate it.
Yeah, we do.
Well, that wraps up our weekend here in downtown Las Vegas. So until our next adventure, we'll catch you guys on the next one.
See you later, guys.